Forever could never be long enough for me. I feel like I've had long enough with you. Forget the world now, we won't let them see. But there's one thing left to do.
I learned how to write it when I first started school. Some bully didn't like it, he said it didn't sound too cool. So I had to hit him, and all I said when the blood came, it's my last name. Grandpa took it off to Europe to fight the Germans in the war. It came back on some dog tags nobody wears no more. It's written on a headstone in the field where he was slain, it's my last name. Passed down from generations, too far back to trace. I can see all my relations when I look into my face. May never make it famous, but I'll never bring it shame. It's my last name. Daddy always told me, far back as I recall, son, you're part of something, you represent us all. So keep it how you got it, as solid as it came, it's my last name. Passed down from generations, too far back to trace. I can see all my relations when I look into my face. And never make it famous, but I'll never bring it shame. It's my last name.
So it goes. some things are meant to be. Take my hand, take my whole life too, for I can't help falling in love with you, for I can't help falling in love with you.
Presenting this woman to be married to this man.
Her mother and I.
I'd like to welcome you all here. As an introduction, I'm John Click. Unfortunately, Jim and I have been friends since we were best friends since we were five. So 46 years have gone by. And I believe the reason that they'd asked me to perform this wedding is when Jim and Brenda were united in marriage, I ran a little bit late that day. So I guess this was one way of getting me here on time. So. It is one of life's richest surprises when the accidental meeting of two little paths lead them to proceed together along the common path as husband and wife. It is one of life's finest experiences when a casual relationship grows into a permanent bond of love. This meeting and this growth bring us together today to celebrate the love and marriage of Jessica and Kirk. Brenda, the mother of Jessica, and Teresa, the mother of Kirk, will now light two individual candles, which are symbolic of the individuality of the couple and their families here at the beginning of this ceremony. First reading will be by Nikki Morrison, who is Jessica's cousin. She will now share with us that first reading.
His hello was the end of her endings. Her laugh was their first step down the aisle. His hand would be hers to hold forever. His forever was as simple as her smile. He said she was what he was missing. She said instantly she knew. She was a question to be answered, and his answer was, I do.
You'll all have to bear with me a little bit. In my advancing age, my eyes aren't as good as they used to be. And when we did all the rehearsal and all, it was much brighter in here. So I don't want to hold a flashlight on this. Jessica and Kirk, as the two of you come into this marriage ceremony to be united as husband and wife, always remember to cherish each other as a unique individual, respect each other, forgive each other, do not hold grudges, and live each day as a gift together. As from this day forward you shall be together, your marriage a tower, a strong tower of love, respect, and consideration for each other. Trust each other with respect and remind yourself often of what brought you here today. Gentle and kind words pave the road of a great marriage. When each of you take responsibility for the quality of your lives together, your marriage will indeed be blessed. Jessica and Kirk, you have learned much in your individual lives. Your family and friends, many of whom are here with you today, have been part of your unique experience and have shared with you hopes, dreams, triumphs, and sufferings. But at some point, the two of you met and your lives changed forever. Now you are here, promising to build a future together. Therefore, let us reflect on the fact that that just as the flame you are about to light is not created solely by either candle, so too your love, not the sole possession or creation of either of you. Jessica and Kirk, the two of you will each light separate candles, which will symbolize your separate lives. I ask that each of you take one of the lit candles and that together you light the center candle. Lighting the center candle represents that your two lives are now joined to one light and representing the joining of your two families and circles of friends into one.
Some people have it, and some people don't. Some people never will. Sometimes it's hard to know when you got it. Sometimes it's perfectly clear. Well, I know it's out there. I've seen it happen. I know the way it should feel. 'Cause there's no mistaking that good kind of aching of a once in a lifetime love. A once in a lifetime love. A love like we've all dreamed of. It may go disguised right before your eyes. Once in a lifetime love. Got it, you feel it inside you. Don't let it slip away. You may not ever.
They're already jumping ahead of me here at home. Already had to have a word with you about holding hands around. Now at this point, if you face each other and hold hands. Kirk, as you look at Jessica, repeat these words after me. I, Kirk.
I, Kirk.
Take you, Jessica.
Take you, Jessica.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better and for worse.
For better and for worse.
For richer.
For richer.
For poorer.
For poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
I promise this from my heart.
I promise this from my heart.
For all the days of my life.
For all the days of my life.
Jessica, as you look at Kurt, I, Jessica, take you, Kirk.
I, Jessica, take you, Kirk.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
For better or for worse.
For better or for worse.
For rich or for poor.
For rich or for poor.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
I promise this from my heart.
I promise this from my heart.
All the days of my life.
All the days of my life.
We'll now go through the exchange of rings. All right, we passed that. I'm surprised you already have it on her. The wedding ring is the outward, invisible sign of an inward and spiritual bond, which unites two loyal hearts in endless love. It is a seal of the vows Jessica and Kirk have made to one another. Bless these rings that Jessica and Kirk, who give them and wear them, may enter, abide in unity, love, and happiness for the rest of their lives. Kirk, please repeat after me. Jessica.
Jessica.
I give you this ring as a symbol of our love.
I give you this ring as a symbol of our love.
And with all that I am.
And with all that I am.
And all that I have.
And all that I have.
I honor you.
I honor you.
With this ring.
With this ring.
I be wed.
I be wed.
Jessica, if you would repeat. Kirk, I give you this ring as a symbol of our love.
Kirk, I give you this ring as a symbol of our love.
And with all that I am.
And with all that I am.
And all that I have.
And all that I have.
I honor you.
I honor you.
With this ring.
With this ring.
I be wed.
I be wed.
By the power vested in me by the state of Illinois, I now pronounce you husband and wife. You may now kiss the bride.
I present to you Mr. and Mrs. St. John.
Lemon drops high above the chimney top. That's where